Good morning, students. In this period, I am going to tell you about graphs of exercise 2.1. The graphs of y बराबर पी एक्स, the graphs of y equal to px are given in figure 2.10 below. For some polynomial px, for some polynomial px, find the number of zeros of px in each case. The figure is given below. In figure 1, the graphs of y equal to px, this graph is given, y equal to px are given for some polynomial px. Find the number of zeros of px. To find the number of zeros of px, we see that the graph y does not intersect at any point. Number of zeros is equal to zero as the graph of y बराबर px does not intersect x axis at any point. According to this figure, we see that graph of y बराबर px does not intersect x axis at any point. So the number of zeros is equal to zero because y does not intersect x axis at any point. Question number 1. In question number 2, figure 2, number of zeros is equal to 1 as the graph as the graph y is equal to px intersects x axis intersects x axis at one point. In figure 2 we see that the graph y is equal to px intersects x axis at one point, so the number of zeros is equal to 1. And similarly in figure 3 similarly in figure 3 number of zeros is equal to number of zeros is equal to 3 as the graph y is equal to px intersects x axis at three points, so the number of zeros is equal to 3. In figure number 2, questions, the graphs of y bar px are given. In all figures, y is equal to px are given, and according to figure, you have to find the number of zeros in each case. So in first case, we see that y does not intersect x-axis at any point, so the number of zeros in figure 1 is equal to 0. In figure 2, we see that the graph y intersect x-axis at one point, so the number of zeros is equal to 1 in figure 2. And similarly in figure 3 we see that graph y intersects x-axis at 3 points, so the number of zeros is equal to 3. In this method you can find the number of zeros in each case. And similarly I hope that you will find the number of zeros in 4th, 5th and 6th cases. And in next class I will start linear equations in 2 variables. So complete this exercise 2.1. Thank you.